Why learn TypeScript? Are you wondering what the fuss is about TypeScript and whether it's worth investing time and energy or whether you should use it in your project? If so, you've come to the right place. Let me tell you my story. A few years back, I tried to learn JavaScript. I'd already coded in C and in C++ and in Lua and in ActionScript and Python. So I wasn't really starting out on my coding journey, but I'd changed jobs and part of the codebase was in JavaScript. And I was trying to understand where a bug was coming from. So I tried to go through the code and understand what was going on, but I was frustrated trying to learn JavaScript. I tried and I failed. I was coming into an existing codebase. I was trying to follow what was going on across lines and lines of poorly documented code. It was frustrating, but in the end, I was able to learn JavaScript. Later on, by first learning TypeScript. And I found TypeScript way more fun to use than JavaScript. And in a way, that's strange. Because TypeScript, in a sense, is a load of constraints. It limits what you can do. It forces you to follow rules that are added on top of JavaScript. And to me, TypeScript is fun in a way that JavaScript is not. Why? What is it about TypeScript that makes it an enjoyable experience? And not just in my opinion, but in the opinion of the thousands of developers who answered the Stack Overflow developer survey and rated TypeScript the third most loved language. It's kind of counterintuitive, but we're going to explore this question together. First, what is TypeScript? What is it useful for? Second, why is TypeScript fun? What makes it fun in a way that JavaScript, to me at least, is not? Third, I'm going to go over how I learned TypeScript and JavaScript via TypeScript. And why TypeScript is a good choice as a learning language. Now first, what is TypeScript? TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript. What does that mean? It means it's first additional syntax on top of the JavaScript syntax that it transpiles down to JavaScript and it anticipates updates to JavaScript. What does that mean? Well, first, any valid JavaScript syntax is valid TypeScript syntax. If you have a page of JavaScript code and you change the file extension from JS to TS, there you go, valid TypeScript code. Secondly, TypeScript transpiles to JavaScript. What does that mean? On a basic level, it means that at the end of the day, TypeScript code is going through the compiler and being output as JavaScript code. And that is what is being executed. And that means that anything that JavaScript can do, and JavaScript can do a lot of things, TypeScript can also do. On another higher level, all this means that TypeScript is not a competitor to JavaScript. It's a tool to produce valid JavaScript that is maybe even higher quality code than we would have produced on our own. But it's not a competitor to JavaScript. It's a tool to produce good JavaScript. You can't execute TypeScript directly in a browser. Only JavaScript can do that. In that sense, TypeScript exists only to improve the experience of coding in JavaScript. I don't know if that was the original intent, but given the high developer satisfaction, it's certainly the end result. And it's the end result for me. Certainly one that I experienced firsthand. So how does TypeScript do that? Well, that is the fundamental question, isn't it? What are the ingredients to the better developer experience that TypeScript provides? What makes TypeScript fun? And why not just use JavaScript? Well, TypeScript improves the developer experience of JavaScript in two ways. First, at its most basic, TypeScript is about adding documentation on top of JavaScript. And if you configure your project correctly, it can force you to do so. And of course, not just force yourself, but any other developers working on the project. And that documentation is partial. It doesn't intend to cover all the information that documentation should provide. But it does provide one very specific information, and that is the type of values that a variable should contain. JavaScript will happily return true to the statement that 0 equals the empty string, but strings and numbers are two very different things. They're two different types. JavaScript is weakly typed or even untyped. In JavaScript, you can assign any value of any type to any variable at any time. And that's a bit of a mess. TypeScript adds type to coding in JavaScript, and there's a clue in the name of the language. That type checking is only done at compilation time, not once the code is being run. It complains if you said that a variable is of a certain type and then you use it differently. That means that TypeScript actually makes you a slightly better coder. It makes your development tools better too. By adding constraints, it helps your tools better guess what you're trying to do and therefore helps you get there faster. And faster is cool, as is better quality. It's been said that 15% of bugs in code are due to type errors. And having worked for over 15 years with a lot of loosely typed languages, most notably Lua, Python, and JavaScript, that 15% feels like an underestimation. The second way TypeScript removes hassle or makes things more fun is that it anticipates future JavaScript syntax, and it allows you to target past JavaScript syntaxes. JavaScript has improved a lot over the years, but when I started using it, there was no fat arrow, no promises, no spread operator. Those were in the works, of course, but couldn't be used because the browsers didn't support them. And TypeScript allowed me to use the nicer, cleaner syntax without worrying about compatibility, because I could transpile the code back to the old syntax, and I could choose the level of compatibility that I wanted the TypeScript compiler to output. And that's nice and refreshing when you've spent any amount of time battling with JavaScript compatibility issues. Of course, things have improved now because these funky new features have made their way into JavaScript and are widely used. But someday, a new shiny feature will be proposed for the JavaScript language, and TypeScript will have it first, because TypeScript necessarily moves faster than JavaScript adoption. And that's also part of what makes TypeScript a good choice to learn and to use. Now, JavaScript is weird. In fact, there is a whole website dedicated to the weirdness that is part of JavaScript called JavaScript WTF. A lot of that weirdness is due to how JavaScript manages types or doesn't manage them. And when learning JavaScript, that weirdness can cause a lot of frustration. TypeScript gives you training wheels when you're learning JavaScript. It keeps you away from a lot of the traps that would cause confusion. Personally, I learned JavaScript a lot faster and a lot better via TypeScript, because TypeScript's mental model was clearer to me, because my IDE would point me in the right direction and would help me complete my tasks a lot faster. It would point out my errors. Now, I'm not trying to start any flame wars here. In fact, giving the Stack Overflow results, I'm not saying anything particularly controversial or revolutionary. But if you want to learn JavaScript, I recommend you start with TypeScript. And if you want to keep learning, I recommend you watch one of these two videos.